So let us start. Today I'm going to cover the part two of our video lecture series based on how to call Weather API using ASP.NET. And now today we are going to see how to call Weather API using PHP. So it's a part two. I have already recorded part one. If you have not seen my part one video, how to call Weather API using ASP.NET, so please visit and see that video, and then you will come here for covering this part two, which covers how to call Weather API using PHP. So let us start. So before starting this how to call the Weather API in PHP, so there are different weather forecasting sites. They are providing weather related details, and one of the important or main site which is providing weather forecasting services from so many years is Open Weather Map. So I'm using the web API provided by the website called openweathermap.org. So this is the home page of this particular site, openweathermap.org. This particular site delivers 2 billion forecast per day. So see the demand of this web API. So billions of forecast per day, 2,500 new subscriber a day. These many customers, and they provide more than 20 plus weather API. So this is what the big achievement for this particular company, that this company is providing these many weather API. We can call this weather API in our ASP.NET client or using PHP client. So they are the web service provider. So this particular organization plays a role of web service provider, and our role is web service requester or consumer. So we are playing a role of consumer, and how to consume this different weather API in our client application. So today I am covering the PHP, how to call this weather API in PHP. We have already seen the ASP.NET. Today our aim is to cover through PHP. If we click on this pricing link, this particular site provide you the pricing detail. They also provide you the free account, and from the free account you can access 60 calls per minute. And they provide API key, a secured API key. And this key is again, we have to use this key in our program. In ASP.NET or in PHP program, we have to consume that URL to call that service. So to call that web API, we have to consume the URL plus API key, secured access, to get the secured access. So they verify. And after verification, they provide the weather forecasting detail for us. So there are different plans. So as per the company's requirement, they can select a startup plan, $40, developer, professional, and enterprise plan. So based on the organization requirement, they can go for different paid plans. So this is what the pricing tag related with this Open Weather. So I'm using this free account for calling the web API. So how to call this weather API? As I have said that you call the weather API, they have provided the path, and this path, we have to include this path in our program. So this API, to call the API here, we have to provide the city name. So you provide your city name, plus for the security purpose, they check your API key, secured API key, and both city name and API key matches in their database. Then they provide the weather forecasting details related to that particular city. Again, what parameter, what information they are providing related to weather forecasting related to that particular city. So these are the different parameters. We are just passing the city name and API security key there, and after that in the response they are providing us different parameters, coordinate. They are providing that city longitude, city latitude, CORD.LON is used to get city geolocation longitude. To get the city latitude, CORD.LAT. So this parameter provided by the particular open weather map file. So weather, more information, weather condition code. So weather condition ID, group of weather parameters, rain, snow, extreme, etc. Weather description. Weather icon ID, some internal parameters. So many parameters is again provided by the that particular site. And as per our requirement, we have to print this information with the help of these particular parameters. So here the few additional parameter provided by this particular sites. To access the web API, secured web API with the help of API key. So first time you have to create the account. So for the new user, you create your account, and opening the account is the process is like this: username, email ID, password, repeat password, and select the checkboxes. So it's a hardly half minutes job. So you open your free account, and after opening the account, sign in link is there. So you just click on sign in, and in sign in you provide your email ID and the password, and you just click on submit button. So after providing the secured user ID and password, you will get this particular message: you are signed in to successfully. So sign in successfully message you will get, and this is what the your requirements. So these are the links provided by this open weather for yourself. New products, the services provided by this open weather file, open weather website. And here this link is again important: API keys. So this link is provided to generate the new API. If afterward, after free account, if I want to shift to billing, so they have provided different billing plan, payment. So let us see my orders, my profile link. So these are the some of the keys I have already generated. How to generate the key? So to generate the key, you just give the key name. Here I have given the key name as TEST, test. I have just click on generate. So the test name key is generated, and these are the key details. I have hidden these key details. So this is secured key. So therefore I have hide this particular key. So you open your account, you create your own keys, and then refer you. I'm going to use this particular key in my application, in my PHP application. So how to test that key and the city name combination is working or not? So you copy this particular line from the website. Where this line is again available, just I'm showing you. See here, API call by city name. So you just copy this name, this particular link, and here Q equal to, you just provide the city name. So here my city name is Ahmednagar. So Q equal to Ahmednagar, and app ID is, in app ID, so after the app ID, I am providing this particular key. So if I have given the combination here, same link is again provided here, Q equal to the city name and app ID equal to my key. So I have hidden that particular key. So you use your own key, secured key, and then just click on enter. So instead of directly writing the application in PHP or in ASP.NET or in Python, before that you test your API key is properly working or not. If the API key is working properly, then only you will get this type of output. This is what the JSON output, JavaScript Object Notation output. And here, as I have said, that they provide you different parameters. This coordinate parameter provide you longitude and latitude. Then some weather related information parameter is provided by weather class. So these are the different classes. Main class provide you important main features of this particular web API. That is the temperature, minimum temperature, maximum temperature, pressure, humidity, sea level, ground level, visibility, speed, cloud percentage, then sunrise, sunset. So this sys class provides you country name, then sunrise, sunset, time zone, etc. details. So if this particular link is running successful, then only you will start the development of the program. So I'm developing, I'm trying to develop the application in PHP. So to start the PHP, I'm opening the PHP environment. So you come to your C colon, then XAMPP, and you start first the XAMPP controller, XAMPP control panel. So you double click on XAMPP control panel. So after opening the XAMPP, you start the Apache server. So after starting the Apache server, you check that your server is running successful or not. So for that, you just click on admin button of this XAMPP control panel. So our XAMPP is running successfully. So our environment is ready. So for running the PHP application, I am required the environment Apache server. So Apache server is running successfully. So let us open the application. So in the XAMPP, to run the web services, you open this htdoc folder. In htdoc folder, just a minute, I'm showing you one. To run the web services or web API, PHP required this particular library files. This library file is available on Google. So you search that library file and install after exploring, you just copy that folder. So that zip folder, so you copy this folder here in your XAMPP directory. So in your XAMPP directory, C colon XAMPP directory, you copy this NU soup. So this is what the web services web API supported with the help of this particular library. So I have already installed this library. I have downloaded this library from Google, and I have installed this library. This library contains some important files, and we are using this file is required at the time of running the PHP application, nusoap.php. So this is what the prerequisite. So you start the environment, you download the nusoap file, you install that folder in XAMPP, and then you start development of the application. I'm developing the application in htdocs as usual. In htdocs, to run the web API, I have created one folder called web API folder. So you remember this particular path. So at the time of running that particular web API, so localhost/web API, and in that web API folder, I have used weather.php web API for calling the weather services. So I've already written this particular program. I'm showing you how this program looks like. Edit with Notepad++. So this is what the program. So let us read this program line by line. I'm explaining you this program line by line. We required the city name. So we are passing the city name parameter and app ID parameter to this particular path. They have provided the path to call the API. They have provided the path. And in this path, I am passing the first attribute is city name and second attribute is app ID. So I have not written the app ID here. So afterward, I am putting the app ID, my secured app ID here, and then executing this particular program. So getting the city name and app ID. So for city name, I required one form, simple form, HTML, body, form, start, form, end. I want one input parameter, city name. So enter city name and one button for submitting that city to this particular PHP program. As I have said that you required nusoap.php. This nusoap.php is available in this particular folder, nusoap folder. And we have to copy this folder in XAMPP folder. So you create the XAMPP folder, and in that XAMPP, you store this library files, nusoap. You download this nusoap from Google. You search this and download. So if I click, I have entered the city name, and then I have clicked on the city, click on the submit button. So city is provided, and you pass that city parameter and app ID and store that information in URL. I have taken one variable called URL, and I'm getting that URL file get content. So get the content to one variable called $data. So after getting that file get contents to this particular variable, then I have taken the third variable called character, char, character equal to JSON decode. So we know that the output we receiving from that particular web API is in JSON format. So JSON decode this particular output, $data, stored in that particular variable, $data. So you just put here the echo command and display that output. But we want that output in proper format, in a tabular format. So for that, I have used some command, table command. So I want one table along with the border, then column span, then I have taken one variable called icon variables to store the icon image. Then I'm passing this particular displaying the file path, this particular variable to display the weather icon. So if the today is the rainy season, then the cloud image is again shown with the droplet of rain. So that image, to display the image, you select this image and store that image in variable, and you display that image. Then I want city name. So I'm taking the city name from this particular variable called character. So dot dollar character, and to call the city name, the name parameter is given. To call the country, sys country. So character sys is the main class and country is the subclass. So in this way, I have printed city name, country name, then country flag, then longitude, latitude, weather description, temperature, pressure, humidity, etc. in a table format, and then you just close the display here, the humidity and table end, the table end in the body and HTML. So this is what the program. So to run the program, we have already seen the environment is ready. Then how to run the program? So for that, we know that the path is web API / weather dot PHP. So the local host, then I have created one folder called web API folder, and in that folder I have created weather dot PHP file. So you just provide the full path for execution. Just enter. Just put the enter sign, enter, then select the city, Ahmednagar. I'm just clicking on submit. So this is what the today's weather of Ahmednagar. If you want another country, you just select the another country. This is Pune weather. So this is what the Mumbai weather. So in this way we can accept the output. Here I have taken one image. The weather image, then city name, then country name, then country flag, longitude, latitude, weather description, light rain, temperature, pressure and humidity. So in this way you retrieve the different parameters. We know that in the presentation I have shown that different parameters are again provided, and you include that parameter in your program. So 20 plus API is provided by OpenWeather. So you can test different API using this particular format, the way. So today I have covered this calling web API using PHP client.